works. Van just got a little bit smarter. That is awesome. Woo! What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Today I have a really exciting product for you. I haven't done a Renogy review in a while, and all my equipment is working great except for solar panels. Almost blew off the roof this summer. It turns out one of the screws came loose. I didn't have a lock washer on it, and we had a massive windstorm driving down the highway, and they kind of like, they didn't come off or anything. It just kind of like popped out. So I mean, it's not that bad, but it's totally my fault. Everything else is working great, but Renogy just came out with a new product called Renogy One. And I'm so stoked to review this and install it and tell you guys everything about it. So without further ado, let's get into it. Be sure to check out my solar system guide. I will link it below. It's perfect for amateurs or anyone who requires a little bit of help installing a solar system for off-grid living. Also, use the discount code Made to Travel when you go to check out off the Renogy website if you're thinking about purchasing the Renogy One M1 controller or any other Renogy products. So this is the Renogy One M1. This is like the main controller. And what this is designed to do is basically provide smart energy control for your camper van, for your trailer, for your RV, for your boat, for your house even, anything you control via solar power. This is going to provide smart control. This controller hooks up to almost every Bluetooth device that Renogy offers, including batteries, charge controllers, inverters, and almost all of my products are Bluetooth, so I'm very excited to get this installed, get it connected, and to be able to just mount this screen. I'm not sure where it's going yet, but to be able to just mount it on the wall and see exactly what's going on in the solar system will be so convenient. It looks like there's also three switches on the side here that you can also wire in, so you could use that for lights, fan, really anything you want. This is just the controller, so this is just the start, to be honest. We have the smart plug, which you also hook up via Bluetooth, and I think I'm gonna plan on controlling my water heater with this. Next up, there are motion sensors. So if motion goes off inside your van, however you mount this, an alarm can be activated on the smart controller, and it can also send you alerts on your phone. Actually, you know what? I went out of order on this guy. So next up is the door and window sensor. So you can mount this to any door or window, opens or closes. The controller will then notify you on the app, wherever you are remotely, and let you know that a door or window has opened. Next up, smart relay. This is probably one of the products that I'm most excited about. You can actually wire this up. So when you walk into your RV, trailer, or boat, or house, or wherever, and your door sensor or your motion sensor goes off, this will automatically trigger, say, the lights, the fan, or anything else you program to come on. And you can do this all through the app or the controller. I'm so excited for this because it's just going to turn this camper van into like a smart home, which is something I've always wanted. I'm also very excited for the security features because me and Kaylee have looked into getting a security system installed for the van, like an auto security. With that comes a large price tag. So this will now allow me to set the motion sensor or the door, the window sensor. And if any of those go off, I'll get a notification on my phone saying whatever's gone off and that I should probably run back to the van and see what's going on. This also seems extremely easy to set up, so let's go ahead and open it up and see what we got in the box. So suspenseful. Got the manual, quick start guide. Wow. We have like the little digital touch screen here, and then we have these touch switches here. On the back, we have a type C connector. We have in, out, for all three switches. We also have an RS-45 port and the positive and negative to power the unit. So it looks pretty basic. I saw this somewhere else online. You can just like balance it there. So might just start out with that since I have no idea where I'm gonna be mounting it and I don't just wanna start cutting holes in the wall. So we will see. Power cable, which looks extremely easy to set up. Basically just hooking up a positive, negative, and it looks fairly long too, which is nice. Installation looks super easy. There's basically just a mounting plate here that you could cut out that hole there and then just stick this to that plate once you've mounted it to the wall. Of course you'd have to run all your wires to it. And this is one of the things that, oh my gosh, I wish Renogy, I knew that this was coming out when we were building our van, because I totally would have wired our van completely different. Like this is such an upgrade. I could have run like all the wiring to this area, but now that the panels and stuff are up, I would have to remove the panels and then run new wiring and stuff. So might have to figure out a location that I can mount this, that I can still use all my wiring, since I'll still be able to use my phone and the DC home app to control everything. But let's get into the sensors here. So this is the smart plug. And I think, you know what? Super simple. So basically you just plug that into any outlet like this one and it becomes a smart plug. And then there's a power button on the side that you can turn it on and off. So clicks twice, green's flashing. I'm sure that's how it connects. It's probably sending a Bluetooth signal out right now, which I am very excited about this because this is definitely going to work perfectly with my water heater. This is the Renogy Smart Relay. Super small. It looks like it would be very easy to mount anywhere. And all you have to do is run power to it. It's pretty basic. There's an in and an out port. And then there's an S1, a K1, a V1, and a V+. So I'm sure those are all just kind of like inputs and outputs. I'll have to look into the actual wiring diagrams, but I'm guessing this would be very easy to stick really anywhere. I'm thinking right now of maybe the fan or even the light switch. So I could just pull this light switch out and then wire it behind here. This is the door and window sensor. So I have two of these door and window sensors. I guess I could put one on the back door, maybe the side door, and even the front door if I wanted to. It looks like there's just some adhesive tape in there and there's two arrows that line up there. And then when the door opens, the sensor will go off like that, door closed like that. And then same idea for the window. I might just use this for two doors. I don't think I'll use it for the window, but I'm not quite sure yet. So we'll see. I just wired this into the battery, super quick and easy, but I really want to get this wired up and see how it works and test out some stuff and pull my phone out and get it hooked up to the wonderful Renogy DC home app, which I think you guys know how I feel about that app, but you know, can't always be super easy. So let's plug this guy in and see what happens. So we got Renogy coming up there on the screen. Pretty nice little logo that definitely looks new. The privacy policy here, which we're just gonna click through, searching for the internet. So this is one of the things, I obviously don't have Wi-Fi in the van. So what I'm gonna do is turn on my phone and you can actually hook this guy up to a hotspot. Okay, so it is updating. While it updates, one of the things about this controller is there is a subscription service. You don't have to have a subscription for service, but basically there's different levels of subscriptions and the higher the level is, the more features you get, like most subscriptions. I would recommend you go in and see what you want to do as far as subscriptions go. If you want things like alerts and to see exactly how efficient your solar system is, things like that, you're gonna have to subscribe to the higher service. But if you don't need those features or use those features, you can definitely do just no subscription and just use the controller. Open up the DC home app, and then it says to click the plus in the top right corner, add Renogy One. DC home would like to access. Okay. Paired successfully. Add devices. Scanning for smart devices nearby. So my battery and my 50 amp DC to DC controller with MPPT is connected to my BT2. So both of those devices should show up. But like the DC home app sometimes has issues doing, is connecting to those. Okay, there we go. Okay, now it's connected. Okay, that's pretty cool. So the screen actually looks exactly like the app looks on the phone, which is really nice. It says I'm getting minus 4.3 amps right now, which makes sense. Time remaining 1 day, 20 hours. Okay, so I don't know how well you guys are gonna be able to see this on the screen, but this is basically the Renogy One screen. So it's obviously touch screen. I can go into the battery and it will tell me the exact same things that the app would tell me. It's got the battery level, capacity, preset voltage, preset current, average temperature, heating module status, and then I can also go into my DC charger. Not charging, battery type, house battery, all this stuff. So that is pretty cool. And then I can also go into devices and add a device if I want to. I can go over to settings, add device, system, display, themes, dark, light. Ooh, join the subscription plan to apply the theme. Look at that. So never, so you can do sleep mode, backlight adjustment, automatic setting. Like that. Pretty basic. These are the switches. They obviously don't come up. I just finished installing a few of the sensors and I'm so excited. They work great. It was really easy to install actually and connect to the controller. I was having a few problems operating it from the app. Well, I've got to show you guys this. So what you can do once you set up your sensors, I've set up the motion sensor, I've set up the smart plug, and I've set up one of the door sensors. And right now I have set up a scene where if you open the door, the smart plug comes on, and when you close the door, it goes off. So you can set up all sorts of different scenes. You can use the relay, you can use the motion sensor, and it is really, really cool. It's very satisfying actually. This is the home display on the Renogy One app, and you guys know it looks the same on the controller. And basically, once you've set up your devices here, you can turn things on using your phone or the controller. Like the smart plug right now, I can just hit on and the light clicks on, and then I can click off and the light clicks off. So you can see that the door sensor is closed. I've set it up just over here on the sliding door, and I'll go ahead and open it, and you guys will see that it'll open. And the light comes on, which is sweet. You can see open there, and then it'll also come up on the device here as open. It looks the same on both. Now I will take you to the scene. So under favorite scenes are all the scenes that you've set up. You can name them different things. There are recommended ones like a low battery alarm, access security, arrive home, those types of scenes. And then there are custom ones to do with the relay. I haven't gotten into the relay yet because I'm gonna need to figure out where it's going. I wouldn't mind doing some sort of wiring of the fan and linking it to maybe the window and the stove. So when we go to cook, open the window, fan automatically comes on, that sort of scenario. To just like start a new scene, you can just go to favorites or recommend or custom or whatever, but you click the plus in the upper right hand here, and then say when, let's see, when a panel switch is operated. I haven't actually done a panel switch, so let's actually do something else. So let's go. When the motion sensor activates, detected or undetected. So, I mean, let's say you forget to turn on the lights. You could say undetected, done. And then the action could be, ideally it would be like shut the lights off, I guess. But you could do smart plug, turn off, done. And then you can do an interruption. You can do the name, you can change the name, and then you can say applying time. So you can do start, and it doesn't have to be all day, which is sweet. And then you can go save, and there it is in your favorites. I'm gonna talk a little bit about the subscriptions here. So there is the Smart Basic, which is $3 a month, $30 a year. There is the Smart Energy, $6 or $60 a year. And then the Smart Life, which is $10 a month or $100 a year. And these include like all different things. Like the Smart Life is theme customization, video chat support, entry alert, smart motion detection, one touch control, all sorts of things. But the thing about that too is ideally you would have Wi-Fi set up like in your RV, your trailer, or your camper van. And that's one thing that I would like to do with this. Just because if I'm going to have these features, I need this to be hooked up to Wi-Fi all the time. And that would honestly make me feel a lot safer and it would be pretty fun to use. I am also gonna have to find a sweet spot to mount this. I'd really like it to be kind of at eye level. So that would be pretty high for me. But I don't know where I'm gonna install it, but I will show you guys. I'll be doing another review down the line and maybe like a 6 month to 1 year review. And show you guys exactly what I love about it, what I don't like about it. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate it. If you have any questions about the Renogy One, feel free to comment below. If you like this video, be sure to like it, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you guys in the next one.